Welcome back. So this is the last topic of your first unit, a case study related to RISC and CISC computer architecture. Okay. So case study is generally nothing but a detailed examination of any cases. Okay. You can take any topic and have a detailed examination or some analytical report approach or some research based approach could be there in a case study. Okay, so here we are going to have a detailed examination of RISC and CISC computer architecture. And I think we have already had a little introduction on RISC and CISC architecture in the previous topic, and we will explore more today here. Okay, we are going to examine the both architectures. Okay, so before that, we will get to know what an instruction set architecture is. Okay, so it is the structure of the computer. It provides the commands to guide the processing of the computer. Okay, so instruction set or instruction set architecture is nothing but a structure, so that issues the commands for processing the execution of instructions in the computer. Okay, so here in this picture it says that we have a computer, we have the software and hardware. Okay, so the intermediate is nothing but the instruction set architecture. Okay, so it is a boundary line between the hardware and the software. Okay, so by means of an instruction set architecture we could achieve whatever we want. Okay, so these are commands that will guide the processing of all the executions. Okay, so generally instruction sets will carry out these operations, like it has various instructions, addressing modes, registers, interrupt, exception handling, memory architecture. So instructions, I think we have seen add A comma B, that's an instruction, is it not? So it says we are adding two operands A and B. So addressing modes, in the previous topic we have seen it is used to identify the operands in the memory, the way to get the operands. There are different ways. Okay, there are different addressing modes to fetch the operands from the memory, and registers. So registers are inbuilt in the processor for carrying out the operations in the processor. And interrupt, we have seen in the topic, in the first or second topic, I think. Okay, so while executing the normal flow, when some immediate attention comes in, like an alarming situation, so there that is an interrupt. Okay, it disturbs the normal flow, and that interrupt has to be serviced. Okay, so interrupt we have seen already in second topic, I think, and followed by exception handling. So some unwanted errors occurring means how that exception will be handled by the computer system. For example, division by zero, that's an exception, is it not? So our program will do normal execution, and when we provide the denominator as zero for the divisor, then there comes an exception. Okay, that will be handled by the exception handler, followed by memory architecture. So it says about the way of accessing the memory content and storing it. Okay, so today we are going to see about two kinds of computer architecture. One is RISC and the other is CISC. Okay, so RISC are reduced instruction set computer. So from the name itself you could get, so it is all of a limited number of instructions. Okay, so those instructions are highly optimized to carry out the computer operations. Okay, then again it is a load and store architecture. It means only by means of load and store instructions it will access the memory. No other instructions are allowed to access it. So only via load and store the memory content could be accessed. So that's what RISC we are saying as an load and store architecture. And of course the instructions generally will have two phases, memory access and execution, is it not? What either the architecture is a RISC or CISC, it doesn't matter. So it will generally, an instruction will have two phases of execution. So first is we need to fetch the instruction, is it not? So only after fetching the instruction the computer have to decode it, what that instruction is, whether that is is carrying out some arithmetic and logic operations, or it does some other operations. So that needs to be identified and executed. So generally instructions will have memory access and ALU. And here this is the processor called as Sun Ultra Spark, which uses RISC architecture. So it means, so in RISC architecture the number of instructions is very very small. Okay, so it was originally defined by the IBM in the 1970s, followed by two universities joined Berkeley and Stanford, that gives the architectural model for RISC. Okay, and the main feature or the characters of RISC is low number of clock cycles per instructions. Okay, so since the instruction is smaller, since the instruction is very simple, so it takes a small number of clock cycles to execute it. Okay, so I think we have seen about a processing time, a formula T is equal to N into S by R. So N is nothing but the number of instruction, and S is nothing but the the average number of basic steps to execute a single instruction. So could you compare here with this feature, low number of clock cycles per instructions, whether it says about N or S? I think you could very well answer it. It is it speaks about S. Okay, so S is nothing but the basic number of the number of steps, the number of steps required to execute a single instruction. Okay, so here instruction is simple, it takes smaller clock cycles to execute it. Okay, and RISC architecture has more registers. Okay, that ranges from 32 and more. Okay, so instruction pipelining is a big feature in RISC, since the pipelining, so we have seen it already, pipelining is nothing but to increase the performance of the computer system, so computer's operations. There is a possibility of overlapping one instruction to the other. Okay, by overlapping we could execute the instructions very fast, is it not? So since here the instructions are quite simple, there is a higher possibility of overlapping one instruction to the other instruction. Okay, so the main feature of RISC is pipelining. Okay, to improve the performance of execution of an instruction. And it has simple addressing modes. We have seen addressing modes in the previous topic. So that related to fetching the operands, the various ways of fetching the operands from the memory. Okay, so these are four important main features of RISC architecture. Okay, so a processor may have RISC or CISC architecture. If a processor chooses the RISC architecture, means that has these features. And coming to the block diagram of the architecture, here the main part is this hardware control unit. So it means it is a circuitry approach to generate the control signals, so where the control signals will help to fetch the respective instructions and data. Okay, so hardwire means it is a circuitry approach that generates control signals. Okay, to fetch and execute the instruction. Excuse me. Hardwire. Okay, so it means a circuitry approach. Okay, it's not a programmable approach where the here the programs are not generating the control signal, whereas the circuits are generating the control signals to fetch the instructions and data. Okay, the instruction could be either in the memory or the cache. Okay, so I think we have discussed about cache memory. So the frequently accessed information can be placed in the cache, so that the processing time of that instructions will be reduced. Okay, so that performance will be generally increased. So we could either get the instruction either from the cache or the memory. So after getting the instruction, that needs to be interpreted, and if it takes an operand, means that has to follow this path to get the operand value from either from the memory or from the cache. Okay, so that cache we are saying here as a data cache. Okay, so it provides the operand values, whereas here it provides the instructions. And here is some of the processor which are of RISC architecture, like MIPS, Power PC, Sun Spark Alpha, RISC VARM, Advanced RISC Machine. So these are the processors that uses RISC architecture. Okay, so with this we'll discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of RISC, and hope you could answer it the advantages very well. So since the instructions are simple, the execution is fast, is it not? And it is hardwired to execute the instructions fast. Okay, so hardware means it will directly contact with the processor, no need of intermediate interpretation, nothing. So, and of course there is a disadvantage of hardwire. So it means in the future, if a new instruction has to be updated or added or want to remove, means it's quite difficult, we need to replace it. Since it is a circuitry approach, the updation is not allowed here, is it not? That is one disadvantage. And less number of instructions and instruction formats also. We have seen various instruction formats like 3 byte addressable, 2 byte, 1 byte, 0 byte addressables, is it not? So here it is a fewer instruction formats are there. So for example, add, so instead of that I'll have the syntax, okay, opcode, then source 1, source 2, destination, we have seen, right, is it not? Add R1, R2, R3. So here it takes 3 operands and 1 opcode. Similarly, add R1 comma R2. So here it takes 2 operands and 1 opcode. So here RISC architecture uses less than 4 formats like that, and its total number of instruction is around 150. Okay, so with this 150 instructions only, all the operation has to be carried out by the RISC processor. Either the operation may be quite simple or complex. Okay, so even if the operation is complex, that complex operation has to be done with this 150 instructions only. Okay, fewer addressing modes in RISC, that to 4. It's a register based approach, more registers are used, and of course the design complexity is less because the instructions are very less. And disadvantage, as I said, hardwired means the cost, it would cost if any instructions need modification. So here the term cost in this sense, it's not quite easier to modify the hardwired the circuitry approach, is it not? We need to replace it. So that's it, the cost. Okay, so in the future, if some instruction has to be added or updated, means if it is a programmable approach to generate the control signals, means it's quite easier. But hardwired, it is difficult. We need to replace it. And RISC does not allow direct memory to memory transfer, only by means of load and store instructions, not apart from these two instructions. Okay, so here only by means of load and store, the RISC processor allows memory access. Okay, here I think we have seen about an instruction move a comma b. So that is not possible here. So move a comma b means move is an instruction. So that will directly transfer between the memory where that instruction is in CISC, okay, not in RISC. And RISC instruction is reduced, but more instructions are required to perform an operation. So what does it mean? So to carry out a complex operation, so that complex operation means it needs n number of instructions to achieve that operation, is it not? It requires more instructions. When the instruction size is reduced and to carry out the complex operation, definitely since each and every instructions are quite simpler, it needs more instructions to take to carry out the complex operations. Okay, so that's the point here we are discussing about it. Okay, so these are some of the disadvantages of RISC processor. And now we will be moving on discussing about the CISC. So complex instruction set computer processor. Okay, from the name itself you could get the instructions are quite complex. So what does it mean? So we could limit the number of instructions. Okay, so using complex instructions, our program size will be limited. So within few lines we could finish out our requirement. Okay, so we could write our program with a limited number of steps. Is it not? So that's because that much powerful those instructions are. So CISC is CISC provides complex instructions so that number of instructions are reduced. Here as we take back our that equation T is equal to NS by R. Okay, so T is nothing but the processing time of any operation or a program is equal to N into S by R, where it's here a number of instruction, it speaks about N. Okay, so total number of instruction is very less in CISC architecture. Okay, since instruction is less because that instruction is of a complex instruction that needs a complex hardware to process it. Okay, so complex instruction means we cannot execute it in a single clock cycle. Okay, that takes various clock cycles to execute it. Okay, it takes more clock cycles, that's the meaning here. So hardware is complex to perform that complex task. Okay, and here are some of the features. More number of instructions where high level programs could be easily designed and implemented. Okay, so we could quickly carry out our operations because instructions are quite complex. We can easily write the program and execute it, but for the execution this CISC processor follows some complex hardware design to carry out. Okay, and it uses limited registers and addressing modes of 5 to 20 addressing modes are available in CISC. And as I said, so it takes a varying cycle time for execution of instruction. So it means since the instruction is complex, it takes more time to execute. Whereas in RISC, it is quite a simple instruction. So simple limited clock cycle is enough. So here, very multi clock cycles. Each and instruction will vary its execution time. Okay. Complex instruction makes the pipelining techniques quite difficult. Okay, what does it mean? So pipelining means the we need to arrange the instruction in such a way that I think pipelining, you will be knowing it, it's an approach to increase the performance of execution by overlapping the instructions. So we could easily overlap the instruction if the instructions are simpler. Okay, so for complex instruction, that overlapping itself is difficult. Okay, it is difficult to overlap. So that's because the instructions are quite complex. Okay, that's the point here it is making out. So complex instructions, in complex instruction set computer, pipelining technique is quite difficult. Okay, so difficult because overlapping the instruction is a difficult task. And in CISC, we have 100 to 200 instructions are allowed, whereas the RISC, we have around 150 instructions. And here the main difference between RISC and CISC is this architecture is micro programming, okay, not the hardware approach. So here micro program control unit, this is the programming approach. It will generate the control signals. Okay, so it means here micro program control unit uses a series of micro instructions of the micro program. So micro program is nothing but a complex instructions. Okay, so n number of complex instruction is a program. Here that complex, so one complex instruction is looks like a program, that we are saying as a micro program. for that execution of that micro program, this machine depends on a series of micro instructions to execute a single instruction. Okay, and this is the duty of the micro program control unit to generate the control signal. So what that control signal is, okay, that gets passed to the control unit, and the instruction and execution flow happens here. Okay, so its job is used to generate the control required control signal. So what that instruction is saying, what that operation is, okay, and that is carried out by this path, instruction and execution path. Okay, so and it could fetch the information either from the memory or from the cache. And some of the examples of CISC architecture is IBM 370 by 168, VAX 11 by 780 and Intel 80 486. So these are some of the CISC processor. It means this processor uses complex instruction set, okay. And coming back to the advantages and disadvantages of CISC, so the code size is smaller. Since the complexer, since the instruction is quite complex, so we could limit our program will be, we could write the program easily with the smaller instructions, okay. So when our program is smaller in size, definitely the memory it takes less memory, is it not? Because the program is smaller. Why program is so smaller? Because the instructions are complex, okay. So using the complex instructions, we can reduce the number of instructions in a program, and which takes the limited memory resource, okay. So execution of a single instruction takes place by means of several clock cycles, because a single instruction itself looks like a smaller programs that needs n number of clock cycles to execute. Okay, execution of an instruction, this is accomplished by means of low level task. Okay, so low level task in the sense that single instruction will have an n number of smaller tasks, is it not? So n number of smaller tasks will be considered as a single instruction, and n number of single instruction will be considered as a complete program execution. Okay, so the execution of a single instruction is accomplished by n number of low level tasks. And complex addressing modes makes the memory access flexible. Okay, so it uses around 20 addressing modes, 5 to 20 addressing modes. It has more complex addressing modes, so that complex addressing modes makes the accessibility of memory more flexible, more easier. Okay, and this is CISC has the instruction that could directly access the memory locations, not only by load and store instructions. Okay, it has instructions like move that could directly access the memory instructions, whereas in RISC architecture the memory access is possible only via load and store instruction. And the disadvantage of CISC is, though the code is minimized, so what happens, minimized means it requires several clock cycles to execute that single instruction. Okay, since that single instruction is it looks like a smaller programs, it takes more clock cycles, and hardware structure needs to be quite complex. Okay, since the software implementation is quite simple, to interpret that program and to execute that program, the hardware complexity is high in CISC architecture. And here comparing CISC and RISC, to perform a complex task in RISC architecture, multiple small instructions are used, is it not? So in RISC, all the instructions are quite smaller. Okay, so to carry out a complex operation, we need n number of instructions to carry out that single complex operations, whereas in CISC the instruction itself complex and we could program using reduced number of instructions, is it not? So it means only fewer instructions are enough to carry out the same operations in CISC, whereas in RISC it takes more instructions. Okay, CISC is used for computers, whereas RISC is for smartphones, tablets and other gadgets. Okay, so generally RISC will be used for smartphones and other gadgets, CISC is for computers. And with this our topic is over. So we have seen about RISC and CISC computer architecture, its features and advantages and disadvantages. Okay, so with those knowledge on the topics we have discussed, I think you could take up this assessment very easily. And first question here is, the computer architecture aimed at reducing the time of execution of instruction is which architecture? So pick one of this, and I think it is quite easier for you to pick. And the RISC processor has more complicated design than CISC. Is it so or not? Okay, so just answer it. You could answer it within a fraction of a moment. And pipelining is a feature in which one? Okay, RISC, CISC, ISA or IANA. Next question, out of the following, which is not a CISC machine? You could answer it very well. And with this, our topic is over and we are completing our first unit, and from next session onwards we will start the second unit. Okay, till then, thank you for everyone.